Folks, this is Sijish here. In this video, we can enable Kerberos for an HDP cluster using Active Directory. So in my previous video, so you might already have seen so how to do the installation and configuration of Active Directory, also how to do a single node HDP cluster. So you can use a multi-node or whatever your configuration you like. So AD is installed and this is my cluster. So I just need to get the IP address and start all the services in my cluster. So I use 8080, then admin. Okay, so this is the initial credential. So I have to log in as administrator user for the somebody. So the services are in stop state. Let me start the services once. Okay, so the same time, let me go to the Active Directory server. So login with administrator privilege. Okay. And from the server manager tools, just select Active Directory users and computers. Okay, so once that is open, so you will get like this. So this is my domain or ream, so hadoop.com. So inside that there are a lot of organization unit. So this is the one which I created for storing all my Kerberos key types, I mean the Kerberos principles for my lab cluster. So you can create a organization unit from here, just right click, so new organization unit. Okay, I'm creating one more organization unit for keeping all my service account. So let me just use service underscore accounts, right? So this is the place where I'm going to place my all the service accounts. Just create one user here, new user. One second. So new user, so HDP service, any name you can use. I'm just using HDP service just to point. Okay, so it's like HDP user, right? Finish, then give some password. Password never expire. I don't want to change the password further. Okay, so this is the user I have created, and if you have multiple service account, you have to create. So actually now when I'm doing a Kerberos enable my HDP server, so it will create some principles in this ream, I mean, so inside this. So I need to create, I mean, I am choosing this as for storing my the principles for my lab cluster, which I'm going to enable Kerberos now. Just delegate this service account full with the full permission on that. So HDP SRVC, and so this is the username, and next I okay, so create this one. I don't know much about these permissions and all, so I'm selecting everything. So so this user should be able to create a query, etc., but I'm selecting the full privileges on this organization unit. So I'm going to create, or my Ambari will create principles under this organization unit. So I just need to make a note of this principle name. Just right click properties, then go to the profile account, I think. So I need to find out if the principal name in detail. Just go to the view advanced feature also list, right? So go to the service account properties, yes, organization, yeah, attribute editor. So here, so you can just go to this attribute editor and find out the distinguished name for this particular user. So this is CN equal to Hadoop service, and organization unit equal to service account, DC equal to Hadoop, DC equal to com. Okay, so we need to remember this one because I'm using this user as admin user for this lab underscore Kerberos organization unit. Also I need to just get the details about this organization unit also. Just OU equal to lab dot lab underscore Kerberos. So this value also I need to remember. So the next and main important thing you need to check is the time in your AD server as well as your Linux machine should be the same. So if you are doing it in an enterprise level, so they have a time synchronization mechanism in place, so no need to worry in that case. So if you are doing in a local VMware based installation, so you need to be verify that, okay, so this is the time and my time zone is IST, Indian Standard Time, and this is the time, okay, so that is fine. And go to my AD and check the timing, right? So this is okay, time is okay, just still you just need to change the time and then check the time zone and the time, okay, so that is matching with my Linux time, so both are in the same time zone and the time is okay. So I need to note down, okay, so just need to get the IP address or host name of the machine where AD is running. Just use command prompt cmd and get the IP address. Sorry, IP config, and it's 139. So this IP we need to note down, and this domain name we need to note down, and this organization unit name also we need to remember, also our survey account we need to use. So I'm okay with this and going to enable Kerberos. Just go to the Kerberos, then enable Kerberos. Here you can see MIT KDC existing active directory, and third one is the manual approach. So I'm selecting the existing active directory. So you need to verify these things because we already did this thing, okay, right. And JC, so this is very important. Java cryptographic extension must be installed or available in your JDK. So if you are doing with Oracle JDK, so you need to add this manually. So Open JDK will add this. So I'm going to add this JC because this part I have not done earlier. So I'll be doing this right away. So I have downloaded this JC policy file corresponding to my JDK version. So you can go to the Oracle website and get this for 1.7 or 1.8, whatever the version you are using. So I'm using this command, and this will unzip and save the files under this location. It's under JRE lib security. That's it. So now I can go back to the terminal and click continue. Okay, so here I need to use that name, or I mean the KDC host IP address or host name. So if you are using the DNS, use that, or else you can add in etc host and use that host name. So I'm using IP here, okay, 192.168.139. So 192.168.232.139. Ream name is hadoop.com. LDAP URL is ldaps:// this one 636, and the container DN. Container DN is the distinguished name for the container or where we are going to add our principle. So this is the one which I selected. So this attribute editor, so OU equal to lab underscore Kerberos, DC equal to Hadoop, and DC equal to com. So use that value. So OU equal to Kerberos, sorry, lab underscore Kerberos. DC equal to Hadoop, comma DC equal to com. So domain is Hadoop.com. So let me check the connection. Okay, so connection failed. It's saying unreachable. Okay, so I need to troubleshoot this because this is saying the connection failed. Okay, so we can go to the Ambari log. So go to the server where Ambari server is running, slash var log Ambari server, and check the Ambari log. Okay, so we will just use the tailf and this one and try to test this connection again. See, now you can see like, so AES 25. Okay, so Java legal exception. So so this is something related to encryption. So because we already installed, so if you are getting this error, so that means something wrong with the JC or Java cryptographic extension. So I think I added this JC sometime later, and maybe I need to restart the Ambari service. So I'm going to do that, or let me verify that JC is completely, the properly done. So let me try that. I think it's already done. So maybe I need to restart Ambari server. Service Ambari server restart. So I did just restarting Ambari, and again, so back to this page. So this time, if I do a test connection, it's working fine. So that error was because, like, so this encryption was not supported. Why? Because I don't have a JC installed, and Ambari was not aware of that. So what I did, I just unzipped this JC into my Java installation path, then restarted the Ambari service again. So back to this page, and so we'll add the remaining parts also. So admin host, then admin principal. So this is the user which we created and give the delegated access on this lab underscore Kerberos. So the username is HDPSRVC. So use that option here, HDPSRVC@hadoop.com. Then use the credentials. Then continue next. So first it's trying to install Kerberos clients, then the testing part. Okay, so this is in progress. You can just check what is happening inside. Right, so GitHub is creating, then it's in good progress. So that is completed. So these two tests has got done. Right. So this is asking for the where to keep our KTAB file in Linux machine, and with the principal name and all other details. And in advanced tab also, we have a lot of options for each and every service. So what is the name of the principal and other options. So I'm not changing anything here. So selecting the default and continue. Okay, so this is the details. So this is the container where I'm going to add my principal and the other details. Just next. So this will stop the service, then create Kerberos principles in Active Directory and get the KTAB file and do the Kerberization, and we'll be starting the service later. So we'll have to wait some time. So this operation normally take some time. Okay, so this is completed. Then next. So this is the part where actually it's creating the principles and key tabs and configuration. Okay, So created the principal, right? So the created the principal and key tab. So now if I go back to my Active Directory and just do a refresh, so I can see those entries are added here. So these are the entries my Ambari Kerberos session wizard added. So they have created the principal for HDF, data node, Ambari, name node, etc. So if you have more services, you can see the more principles. So these principles are added by Active Directory, the Ambari Kerberos session wizard. So we'll go back to the page and see the status. Yeah, this is done. So now once everything is done, so it's trying to start the service. So if you go to the directory, etc security key tabs, so this directory contain all the key tab files that Ambari has stored. So for Ambari server, for each and every service, so it's taking the key tab file. Okay, so by using that key tab, so it's trying to start the service. So it again take time because the services has to start one by one based on the number of services. So this will this time will vary, so you have to wait some time until this finish. So now the starting and service test has completed, so you can complete this wizard. So now so we have enabled the Kerberos, so the cluster is working with Kerberos. Okay. So this is the details about the principles and the configuration. And also if you look like, so you want to regenerate the key tab, so the key tab will be regenerated under this location. And in Active Directory, so we use the separate organization unit for storing the service.